Dear traders, in this video I will show you how to backtest trading strategy on MetaTrader, and as well I will compare some results that we have from EA Studio with the backtest in MetaTrader, so you will see that is the same thing. Now I have run here the reactor for euro dollar on H1 chart. I have already 23 strategies in the collection, and let's have a look at the first one, where I have a very simple strategy: entry rule stochastic signal, exit rule envelopes. We have stop loss of 95 pips and take profit of 70 pips. Very simple strategy with one entry and one exit condition, but you can see a great balance chart. And this strategy did 542 trades for the last 5 years and net profit of $4,114, which is for 0.1 lot. Okay, if I increase the lot to 1 and I click on accept, it will be 41,143. So it depends on the lots that you are using, but I will go back to 0.1. And especially if you are trading with smaller accounts, you need to use smaller lots. Now for the strategy, we can see a lot from the report. This is where we have a lot of statistics in EA Studio. And we have as well the report, something we have in MetaTrader, and as well we have the journal that we can compare with the backtest in MetaTrader. As well we have the balance chart, we have the indicator chart, really great. You can see exactly where the trades were open and closed. So for example, here we have a long trade open. Let's see one more time what was the entry rule. Stochastic line crosses the signal line upward, going to the report indicator chart, and here is the cross, and what happens, the take profit was hit. This green line shows where is the take profit, and if I look previously, here is a short trade, here we have the cross, take profit is hit. Before that, a long trade that lasts for a little bit longer, here is the cross, and then we have a long trade, take profit was hit. Here is a short trade, we have a cross downwards and the take profit was here. Consecutive profitable trades over here. Let me show you some negative trade. Every strategy has negative trades. Keep that in mind. And let me find one. Okay, this one here. We have a short trade, the stochastic cross downwards, and we have the stop loss hit. Every single strategy has losing trades. Of course, we are looking for the strategies that have more profits than losses, or what I said, profit factor. The net profits divided by the net losses. So when I set the acceptance criteria in the reactor with profit factor above 1.2, I have really great strategies, and you can see that I have more profits than losses. Now, what I want to show you in this lecture is how to backtest trading strategy using the expert advisor. I will go back to the editor and I will export this strategy for MetaTrader 4. You can export it as well for MetaTrader 5. Depends which platform you use. Now, I will open the MetaTrader and I will paste the expert advisor here. I will go to File, Open Data Folder, and then I click on MQL4 and I click on Experts. I will paste the expert advisor from my downloads folder, and here it is. One more time, for MetaTrader 5, you need to open the expert advisor with the meta editor and you need to compile it. For MetaTrader 4, you can go to expert advisors, right click and hit on refresh. This will compile the expert advisor, and here it is. Euro dollar for H1 chart. And if you want to trade with this expert advisor, make sure you enable the auto trading. It must be green. If you want to do just a backtest, you don't need to enable the auto trading, so you will avoid opening trades. And in order to put it over the chart, you either drag it or double click on it. From inputs, you can see the stop loss, take profit, The entry lot, you can change it from here if you want to increase it or decrease it. And we have the parameters for all the indicators. Below we have the magic number, which is very important, especially when we trade with many expert advisors, what I will show you in this course. The magic number allows us to follow the performance of each strategy, and it's very useful when we are doing portfolio trading with expert advisors. I click on OK and the expert advisor is attached on the chart, and you can see there is a set phase because I disabled the auto trading. I don't want to open trades with this strategy right now. I just want to show you the backtest. I right click and I go to expert advisors and I click on strategy tester. A new window will open below, and here we can set the expert advisor. Usually it will be the one that we have on the chart, the symbol. As a model, you need to use open prices only. This is because the expert advisors from EA Studio, they open trades on the opening of the bar. When there is a new bar coming, it checks for the entry rule. If it's true, it will open the trade. So I click on open prices only, and as period I have H1 and I have spread of 10, which is okay. It is rounded to the higher number. As we said, this is better for the backtest. The current spread with euro dollar is 2-3 points. But I will backtest this strategy with 10, which is more pessimistic backtest and more realistic. I don't wanna test it with 2-3 points. And because we have floating spread with most of the brokers, there will be times when the spread will be higher. So this is how we do it more pessimistically, and it's the better thing you can do. If I click on start, you will see how quick is the backtest. This is because the code is great, no mistakes, no errors. If I go to journal, you will see there are no errors. And if I go to the graph, what you will notice is the very same graph as what we have in EA Studio, but here it is on much smaller window. Here is the bigger one. Let me compare it one more time. Yep, it's pretty much the same thing. And I will show you in details that it's the same thing. Let's see here how much profit this strategy made. So here are all open trades for the period. And at the end, we have about 13,529. What we have in EA Studio, it is 14,114. From where comes the difference? From the historical data. Let's go to the editor one more time. What we had was data starting from 15th of July 2015. This is what I have set in the data horizon. So let's see now what data range we have in MetaTrader. How can I do that? I will press the home key on my keyboard and I will go to the beginning. I will take the crosshair. What we have here? Yep, it is 10th, 11th of December 2015. Couple of months are missing. So what I need to do is I will need to make it the same as much as I can. So 10th of December, I will go back to the data horizon in EA Studio and I will enter 10th of December. 10th of December 2015, and I go back to the strategy. So what we have, 10th of December, and I have 13,546, okay? Very close to what we have in MetaTrader. Now, there might be a very small difference because the MetaTrader backtest is not good as the EA Studio backtest is. And I can go to details about it, but I really don't want to make it boring of how MetaTrader backtest works. I will just give you a quick example. If we have a very long candle like this one, and we have a trade open, and then if the stop loss or the take profit are within this candle, the MetaTrader will take the positive outcome. Okay, because it doesn't know what happened inside the bar, the price went up and down, it will take the positive outcome, which is sometimes misleading, and this could happen with some strategies quite many times in the backtest. And EA Studio takes the negative result. So again, it works on more pessimistic backtest outcome. All right, so let me compare some of the results at the end of the backtest just from the last couple of days. In EA Studio, I will click on report and here are all the trades that happened. I will go to the last page and have a look at some of the trades that we have. And actually the data that we have from Dukas Copy that we have downloaded from the free historical data app is until midnight yesterday. So from there we can have the very small difference in the final result with the backtest. Now let me try to make them both visual. I will try to fit it on my screen so you can see clearly the trades. Yep, I think this way it will be visual. Now what I have on the 13th of July, I have a sale, and let's say on 13th of July, yes, open short, it is at 10 p.m. It is 10 p.m. on MetaTrader as well, and the price is 113.52. 113.52. Stop loss 114.48, 114.48. Take profit 112.83, 112.83. I'm not looking at the last digit, which is the point, because it depends on the spread. It depends if it's floating or not. And there might be a little bit of a difference with the final profit. Let's see one more trade. For example, the one that opened on the 10th of July. What is it? It's a buy at 112.70. And it is at 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock, the 10th of July, we have 112.70 long trade. All right, so for the very beginners, the backtest matches from EA Studio and MetaTrader, which shows a very simple thing. The expert advisors and the strategies that we built with EA Studio, they are real. They have a real backtest, not just in EA Studio where they were created, but as well on MetaTrader. And one more time, the backtest in EA Studio works much better, much faster than the backtest on MetaTrader. And we have much more statistics, which are very useful to improve our trading strategies. All right, I will leave now the reactor working, but before I show you the results, I will record one more video where I will show you the four different ways to test expert advisors, and I will show you which is the method that I like the most, because it's the fastest, it's the most reliable way, and it works really nice for me. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next lecture.